Good day, Pigeon, everyone, especially to you, Mom. It's me, Arenite C. Lala, from Bachelor of Science and Social Worker 1A. So for today's video, I'm going to discuss my topic that I have here, which is the interacting with history through historical shrines in museums. So later on, I'm going to discuss why the shrines in museum is important to the study of history. Everyone, please be with me because now I'm going to discuss the remaining discussion, which is the interacting with history through historical shrines and museum. Everyone, at the end of this video, you will be able to have an idea on why visiting historical shrines and museum is important to the study of history. And also, you will be able to have a deeply understand the purpose of shrines and museum. And lastly, you will be able to know what to do upon arriving on a historical shrines and museum. We have been discussing ways to study the past through a variety of sources that are available to us. While research is a valuable tool to learn more about the experience of the nation in our history, there are existed venues where we can experience history, and these are the shrines and museum. Okay, let's define first, what is the difference between shrines and museum? Shrine is a sacred or holy space dedicated to a specific deity, ancestor, hero, martyr, saint, demon, or similar figure of respect, wherein they are venerated or worshipped. So, shrines often contain idols, relics, or other such objects associated with the figure being venerated. Okay, ito yung mga taong pinarangalan. For example, is ang Dr. Jose Rizal Shrine in the Pitan City. So, makikita mo dun yung mga parangal ni Dr. Jose Rizal at yung mga writing niya with his own penmanship. Lahat ng kasaysayan na ginawa niya, makikita mo sa Shrine Rizal in the Pitan City. Museum is an institution that cares for a collection of artifacts and other objects of artistic, cultural, historical, or scientific importance. So, many public museums make these items available for a public viewing through exhibit that may be permanent or temporary. Why is visiting shrines and museums is important to the study of history? Historical shrines and museum is not only to improve our knowledge, but also to give a new lesson and new study of the past. By this, we can learn how people living in the old lifestyle and what they did to survive para ipaglaban ang ating bansa. Do you ever think what is the purpose of the shrines and museum? Shrines and museum tend to collect, preserve, interpret, display object artistic, cultural, and specific significance for the education of the public. Take note that the shrines and museum represent the pieces of past. Ang mga lugar na ito ay para sa kasaysayan ng mga pamumuhay ay nagbibigay sa atin ng tiyak na otoridad at pagkakatiwalaan sa maaaring makakaapekto sa paraan ng pagtingin natin sa nakaraan. Through interacting with artifacts such as a World War II rifle and the clothes of a Filipino hero, we can better imagine the past beyond the mere letter and words we read. Sa madaling salita, batay sa mga sulat lamang ang mga lumang monumento at krusali ay ang salamin ng ating kasaysayan. Kasi tinutulungan tayo nito upang mas maunawaan ang mga taong nabubuhay sa iba't ibang panahon na may iba't ibang pananaw at kasaysayan at tradisyon. Historical shrines and museums serve as a portal past. But when you are visiting shrines or museum, you must be prepared. In fact, must read the background of the place you will visit. Kasi upang malaman mo kung ano ang aasahan at mailalagay mo ang kahalagahan ng lugar ng iyong bibisitahin sa National Historical Narrative. Okay, so next, what will you do upon arriving at Historical Shrines or Museum? So, ang unang-una na dapat natin gawin when you are in a shrines or museum, dapat nating tignan or hanapin ang historical marker. So, ano nga ba ang historical marker? One thing that you can do is to look for the historical marker. So, this marker put up by the National Historical Commission of the Philippines or NHCP or formerly the Nation Historical Institute or NHI. So, this they provide the basic detail on what makes a certain site historical. So, this marker ensures that the site where it is located is indeed of historical and cultural value to the nation. Additionally, the instructor or professor who will handle your course or will organize your visit to the shrine and museum should provide you with a hands-out or worksheet to accomplish while you are in the site. So, maybe they can assign you to make a reflection paper that reflects your own critical evaluation of the site. So, that's why it's an essential to read every caption or text accompanying artifacts or exhibit on this place. Okay, so yung ibang mga museum ay pumapayag na kuhaan ng litrato ang mga artifacts upang magamit mo ito kung sakaling magbibigay ng aktibidad ang iyong instructor or professor. Shrines and museums are a lot interactive now and aided by available technologies. So take the chance to participate in these interactive opportunities to experience history in a first hand. Watch video, listen to the artifacts, since artifacts are also facts that are open for reading, interpretation, criticism, and evaluation. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new and hopefully you appreciate the effort. It's me, Alinette C. Lala, from Bachelor of Science in Social Worker, and I believe the simple sayings that never say I can't, but always say I'll try.